Which do you prefer, author or authoress?
I really don't see what sex has to do with it. Do you?
With the legendary writer, Miss Laura Lansing. Miss Lansing's latest novel is called Penthouse Paradise. This is actually your second novel with the word penthouse in the title. Do you like penthouses?
Well, I should. I live in one. I think everyone should. It gives one a perspective on life. The spirit soars.
I'm here, Janet.
Yes, Miss Weems.
Hello, Larry.
Hello. I know I'm a bit early.
Oh, that's all right. She's had her run and her swim. She's on the telephone, of course.
I'll be as quiet as a mouse.
Je trouve que la robe est un merveille. Un génie comme toujours. Nous prenons un photo avec la. En effet, je suis sûr que les journalistes deviennent fous.
Want any coffee?
Le
chapeau qui va avec le costume. Oh, that hat. I love that hat. Merci. Merci mille fois. Je t'embrasse. Ciao. Yves Saint Laurent. You're not due today. You're due tomorrow.
I know, dear. But there was some urgency.
What about?
About the new book.
Sit down. If you sit in that chair and push that little button, you'll get a massage.
Oh, well, lower back would be nice. Oh, I've had such pain.
Push lower back. What about the new book?
Well, Laura, dear, I'm afraid I have some rather unpleasant news.
Oh?
I hardly know how to say it.
Just say it.
But the fact is, Wilborn and Fennec don't want it.
Don't want it? What do you mean? Don't want it?
Look, how do I turn me off?
I'll turn you off. What do you mean, Wilborn and Fennec don't want it? They published me since I was a child. I made millions for them.
Darling, you were a sensation in your 20s. A household word in your 40s, an institution in your 60s, but in your...
Watch it. Why don't they want it?
Now, Laura, dear, you mustn't get yourself...
Doris, call Barbara Walters. Tell her I can't possibly lunch with her today. Tell her I'm dead. God knows I may be by lunchtime.
What's wrong?
What's wrong? I'm chopped liver. I'm down the drain. I'm out with the garbage.
You'll feel better after you're rubbed down.
Why?
Well, they seem to feel you've lost touch.
Lost touch? With what?
With the real people. Normal people. Well, they feel you don't know them. What they're like, how they live,
What do you mean, real people? Look at today. Barbara Walters, Clint Eastwood, Jackie Onassis, a little late supper with Calvin Klein. Just folks.
Whose folks?
My folks.
Penthouse Paradise isn't selling.
Who says?
Laura, it is not selling. I know this isn't proper agent talk, but you are of a certain age.
Watch that.
I'm sorry, darling. Did you have plenty of money? And I've been wondering if you've ever given any thought to, well, closing shop.
Closing shop?
Yes, dear, take life easy.
You mean not work? Not write? That's death. Don't worry, Larry. If poor old Wilbur and Fenwick are out, I'll get me another publisher, but I'll keep on writing. I expect to go to my grave typing. Real people. Just as real as they are. Just as down to earth underneath, that is. Look out there, Larry. All those darling people working away. You could plop me down in any one of their dear little homes, and I'd fit right in like a cozy old aunt.
Don't make me laugh.
I would remind you, Larry, that when I was writing Love Could Be Cold, I spent nearly a month in an igloo with 8 Eskimos. And I survived.
Yes, did the Eskimos. Darling, I love you. You're adorable. But in a house in the suburbs with a normal family, you wouldn't last a week.
Would you care to bet?
I'm Walter Gompers. I work in the accounting department.
Oh, yes.
Can you take these for me?
Thank you.
Morning, Mr. Baumgartner.
Oh, good morning, Lorraine.
Have a nice day.
What? Oh, yes. Thanks.
What exactly is the bet?
That I could spend a week with a so-called normal family living somewhere outside of New York City. I could telephone, but no escaping to Manhattan. If I stick it out, Larry has to pay the lucky family $500 a day for their trouble. If I can't, I pay.
$500 a day?
And what? If I lose, I give up writing.
Oh, Laura. Oh.
When your agent is urging you to quit, you pretty much know where you stand. Don't you, dear?
But surely you're not going through with this silly bet.
I never will. Besides, there's nothing to worry about. Larry has to come up with the normal family. And Larry hasn't known anyone normal. In years.
I'd appreciate it if you could send that over right away. Thank you.
Hi.
Oh, hi, Mr. Baumgartner.
Busy, are we?
Well, yes, I have to get this report finished. Mr. Baumgartner, could I talk to you about an idea?
How long have you been with us?
Gompers. 9 years. You see, sir, I have this idea for the accounting department that I think would improve...
Much of our commute?
What?
Well, from where you live to here, for instance.
portal to portal about an hour. You know the Long Island Railroad.
You live on Long Island?
Hicksville. It's not far from Levittown. We like it out there. About my idea, sir.
We? Who's we?
My wife and the kids.
Oh, you have children. How many? What age?
I have a photograph. Would you like to see it?
I'd love it.
That's my wife, Melody. Hmm. Kind of a funny name, isn't it? Well. Before we were married, her name was Melody Lane. She kind of liked it, but I was glad when she changed it. Melody Gomper sounds more like her.
Excuse me. Your Xeroxing's done, Mr. Gompers.
Thank you, Violet.
You're certainly welcome. Oh, excuse me, Mr. Baumgartner.
Walter. Walter. Do you live in an apartment or a house?
Oh, we have a house. It's not paid for yet. It's in a very nice area.
Have you a guest bedroom?
You want to visit?
Is it true, Miss Lansing, that you were intimate with Gandhi?
Oh, I wouldn't say intimate.
Oh, I didn't mean intimate, but you knew him.
Of course.
What was he like?
He was sweet.
And didn't you dine recently with Queen Elizabeth in London?
Oh, yes, yes, I did.
What was she like?
She was regal.
Are these the dishcloths that are on sale?
Guess what happened today?
Hi, honey.
Mr. Baumgartner, the executive vice president of the whole agency in charge of some of the biggest clients we've got, came to my office today.
No.
Didn't call me to his, came to mine.
I still don't get it.
We can make a cool $500 a day for doing nothing. Just nothing.
That's what I don't get. Annette, will you please turn that racket down? You're supposed to be doing your homework.
She wants a change, you said.
Now, please, honey. Who?
I told you, you wouldn't tell me. Actually, though, I think maybe what we're dealing with here is Mr. Baumgartner's mother.
Walter Jr., help Malcolm.
He's got to go to the bathroom.
I'm watching the show. Just do it. If she wants a change, why doesn't he send her someplace fabulous like Atlantic City? Turn it down, Annette.
The impression he wants her to have the pleasure of being with a nice, normal family.
Oh. He's in jail.
If I turn on the music, I can't concentrate. You want me to concentrate?
I want you to turn down the music.
Honey, please turn down the music.
Okay. Don't blame me if I turn into a total nerd.
You won't. Maybe she just wants to get out of Manhattan and breathe some fresh air.
Yeah, the air stinks here.
Maybe we can finally pay for Annette's teeth.
You want some ice cream?
No. Okay.
Oh, they were out of chocolate chip.
Don't worry about it.
Walter, this Mr. Baumgartner, he's pretty high up, isn't he? I mean at the office.
Executive vice president.
Walter, you know what?
What?
This could be it.
What's it?
Your promotion.
I never noticed me. 9 years.
When you tell him your idea, he'll notice you now. Oh, honey. Maybe we could get a new dishwasher. Don't let your ice cream melt. How old is she?
He didn't say. I did ask. All I'd say was she's getting on.
Getting on?
It's always said.
Getting on. That could be really old. She could be an invalid. Gee, I wonder if we could get one of those handrail things so she can get in and out of bed on her own.
You're talking money.
Who's going to care for her food?
Oh, I said we would. How much more can she eat? Another hot dog? A little more soup? It's a gesture on our part.
That's nice, Walter. I'll be back at 5. Have you got any money?
Now, why should I need any money?
You should always carry some money just in case. Here. Take this. Tell them I'm out. Hello? Oh, hello, Larry. Yes, she's here. All right. He says it's important. It's about your bed.
Yes, Larry. What? Well, next week, I'm going to be at a convention in California with Jane Fonda. Something about a coastline. No, I never welch. What? An accountant? 3 children? Normal? Hicksville?
Now listen, Wally. We don't know this person, but I'm sure she's a very sweet old lady, and we want to be very kind and considerate to her.
Is she poor or something?
I don't know, but if she is, we won't say anything, will we? Hmm?
Oh, no, that was a mistake. Don't like that. That's okay.
You may want some of these.
What shall I take, Doris? I want to fit in.
Simple. Something simple.
You mean white? All in white. A filmy, diaphanous white. I don't want to look like the ghost of Marley. Oh, I know, Janet. There's that robe the Dalai Lama gave me. What do you think the dear little housewife will wear? Gingham?
Of course not. You're not going to the Old West, you know.
Aprons, I suppose, day and night aprons. Nothing but aprons as far as the eye can see.
I don't want to sleep down here.
Think of it as an adventure.
There aren't any windows. What do you want windows for?
Well, for one thing, ventilation. And who knows? I might want to look out, see if it's raining, see if it's day, see if it's night.
You can come upstairs for that.
Here, help me with this cot. I hate this cot.
Walter Jr., I have had about enough. You love this cot. You said it was just fine when Grandma came.
I lied.
Please, please cooperate. I'm nervous enough as it is, hmm? Now go upstairs and bring down anything else you think you'll need. Get Annette to help you.
She's not here.
Where is she?
Who knows? She went off with some boy after school.
What boy?
Some boy.
Annette, turn that off and go to sleep, honey. I just wanted to say good night.
Good night.
Honey, it's Saturday night.
Have you got everything, Howard?
I think so, Miss Lansing.
Good.
Why all the luggage? It's only a week.
I want to look right. Where's my typewriter?
Oh, Lord. Now, who's going to cook for you?
The dear little housewife, Emma.
You just can't eat anything. You'll need the best. And you need it specially prepared.
I'm sure she wouldn't dream of giving me anything but the very best.
Mm. Here's a nice little patty I made for you to nibble on.
I'm gonna miss you, Ed.
Oh, yes.
Okay, I got it.
Good.
You plan to do some writing?
Why not? I'm a writer, ain't I? All the houses are exactly alike. How do they know which one is theirs? Oh, how green the grass is. But I'm sure they get a sunset. How do you do?
I'm Laura Lansing.
Oh. You must be Mr. Gompers. Is your wife given to seizures?
Not that I know of.
I think she's coming around.
She should have been told. The excitement has been too much for her, you poor dear. Are you a fan of my books?
No.
Well, then, why?
I've seen you on talk shows. You scare me to death.
Shall we go in?
Yes, we should. What are these? Oh, the progeny. How do you do? I'm to be your house guest. Yes, I can see they're thrilled. What a charming little country cottage.
Oh, you move. You move. You move.
Yes, dear. If I'd known it was you, I'd have.
Yes, dear.
Change the wallpaper.
I should have phoned ahead. Howard, fetch the champagne, please. I brought a case of champagne just in case we had a thirst.
We don't drink, usually.
Can we go now? Please, everyone. I would like to say a word. Dear friends, dear Gompers, I want you to know one thing about me. I am without ego. Well, I mean, I do have no ego, but I want to be treated as if I was simply one of you. I assure you, I won't intrude on your little lives in any way. You'll never know I'm here. Just go about your business as if I didn't exist. Howard, there are two bottles cold. Larry, do give him a hand. Isn't it a bit warm in here? Airless. Ah.
Let me help you.
Oh, no, I never need help.
Where's the sweet old lady?
Hush, dear.
Now, may I see my quarters, please?
Oh, of course. This way. I've tried to make it nice for you, Miss Lansing.
I'm sure it's simply lovely.
There's a copy of Valley of the Dolls there.
You shouldn't have troubled. Where's the telephone?
In the living room.
My telephone.
In the living room. Well, we've been thinking of getting an extension, but Walter's out
of course. Now, may I see my bathroom, please?
Surely. Excuse me.
What is this awful cacophony? Oh.
Who do you think you are?
I know perfectly well who I am. Let me see your eyes. absolute confusion.
Mom!
I'm sure she meant it as a compliment. The bathroom. Right this way. See, it's, very convenient.
Oh. I'm a real stickler for hygiene, and I must ask that nobody else use my bathroom.
Laura, I don't think you've got the drift. Am I not right, Mrs. Gompers, when I say that in this house there's just one bathroom?
What are these poor people to do? Well, we'll think of something, won't we?
Yeah, what?
Hello, Shorty. What's this?
I'm afraid the Gompers are a little low on champagne glasses.
Can't you stick something in his mouth? I mean, a cookie or something.
He's just not used to you.
I'm not used to him, but I'm not screaming. Yet. Here's to the real people. The real people.
Mom, is she coming out again tonight?
I don't know, sweetheart. Keep your voice down.
Hmm? Why can't we turn on the TV?
It upsets her, I guess.
What's she doing in there?
I don't know, Walter.
Why didn't she eat dinner?
I don't think she cares for beefaroni.
But boy, does she care for that chopped liver she brought.
I guess she was hungry. I smelled it. It stank. She is so famous.
She writes books.
You don't know, Walter. She's on all the talk shows. She goes out with Robert Redford and she knows Steven Spielberg and the Queen of England and the Pope.
Really? Steven Spielberg?
Isn't this pleasant? Is this what you do in the evenings? Sit in meditation? I've got it. A schedule. The bathroom, I think I've solved our problems. Now, Melody, you're the first in the morning because you have chores to do to get your little family going. You've got a full 20 minutes. Walter's second, of course. He's the breadwinner, has to train to New York, bring home the bacon. You've got a full 20 minutes. You're the daddy. The children follow. And at first, because she's a girl, I don't think we should mind a little discrimination in gender. Then Walter Jr. They each have only 10 minutes, and they mustn't dawdle because they got to get to school. Malcolm. Don't do that, Malcolm, or I'll pack you in a suitcase. Yes. Malcolm then has 10 minutes, which is more than he needs. You'll note that I've put myself last. Although I'm a guest, I am also an outsider. And I don't mind being last, because then I can be open-ended. So, to speak. Now, Walter, if you've got a hammer, you can put this right up on the bathroom door. Just as Martin Luther did on the door of the Wittenberg Church in 1517. Oh, Melody, could you be a dear and make me a little more closet space? Oh, not tonight. The morning will be time enough. And, dear, I sat on my bed and it's much too soft. I'm going to need a board under the mattress. And I am a writer, you know. I need a proper desk. Good stout chair and a decent lamp. And quiet, of course, that goes without saying. Good night, all. Bless you.
What did she mean, a board? Where would I get a board?
Why here?
Or a desk.
Why us?
Or a good stout chair.
don't even know what a good stout chair is.
What's she doing here?
Or a decent lamp. Where am I going to get a decent lamp?
I just want a promotion.
I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, it might be just as well.
For a brisk trot. Startled some of the natives, though. Good morning, Malcolm. Good morning. Why do you do that? Now, look at me. You study my face. You tell me what you see there.
Hold. Mark.
The child's hopeless.
Do you need anything pressed?
Not now. No, maybe later in the day I'll let you know.
Thank you. What do you have for breakfast?
Fruit, just fruit. Little kiwi would be nice.
Kiwi.
Who's in there?
Me.
Well, get out.
I think all I have is a banana.
He's making a mockery of the whole system.
Oh, that's Walter. He was so anxious, I guess, about, you know, staying on schedule that he forgot to shave.
You mean he went back in?
Well, he had to.
I don't see why. Anything you forget to do while you're in there, you have to wait to do until you're on the schedule again.
Oh.
Bill's character.
Yes.
Annette! Honey, come on! Breakfast! Keep playing here. You're gonna be late for school. Come on, Annette! Did you sleep well?
Of course not.
Walter Jr.!
Good morning, Walter.
Junior.
Walter Junior.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
No, thanks. Just a little herbal tea.
I hate sleeping down there, and that cot's too hard.
I'm sorry, I don't have any herbal tea.
Oh, no, it doesn't matter. Never mind. Twinings will do.
Ned stayed in the bathroom too long. I timed her. She was 30 seconds over.
Twinings?
Coffee.
Annette, I told you, you cannot wear that skirt to school. Now, I ironed the other one for
Why
you.
Why not?
Because you're not Tom DeLeo.
Who's Tom DeLeo? Probably a friend of Miss Lansing's. Now, Annette, please, change it.
It's what everybody's wearing, and I'm going to wear it.
Well, I did stock up for breakfast. Eggs and bacon and...
No, thank you. I think I'll stick with my banana.
Why don't you eat some of these?
Crispy, crunchy sugar supers. If you continue to eat these, Walter Jr., your body will turn into putty and your brain will dissolve into tapioca.
Huh? He likes them. Oh, is it all right?
Well, what is it?
Well, it's coffee.
It can't be. Real coffee.
Well, no, instant.
I prefer it. It's what I drink at the office.
Mm. I'll go shopping this morning. Walter, I'll need the car, so I'll drop you off. Oh, I just remembered Malcolm ate the banana last night. I'm so sorry.
It doesn't matter. I've often fasted by way of penance during difficult periods in my life.
Thank you.
Walter, what am I going to do?
Honey, just ignore him. Forget I made an appointment to get the oil change this morning.
You won't be late again tonight, will you? Please? Please don't leave me alone.
I'll try.
Goodbye. Goodbye, dear children. Study hard. Nose to the grindstone. Shoulder to the wheel.
Oh.
Good morning, Walter. How did it go, first night and all?
Fine. Fine.
Really?
Well, she has opinions. I guess you know that.
Well, I have noticed once or twice.
Mr. Baumgartner, I'd really like to talk to you about my ideas for advice.
Another time, Gompers. Everything is really fine at home, eh?
Oh, yeah. Fine. Fine. Well, we were wondering, why would you pay us $500?
Walter, just think. She's alone. She's always been alone. No husband, no children. Just emptiness and silence.
Yeah.
What a thrill for her to be part of a rollicking, fun-loving family like yours. Walter, you just be yourselves.
Oh, excuse me, Mr.
Baumgartner. Excuse me. Just be yourselves.
Lunch?
Junior's bed. Not my dresser.
I know I should have. I get carried away.
How did you do all this by yourself?
I'm stronger than I look. The mailman came, charming man, he pitched right in. It's only for a week. Pity they don't have caviar. Such a comfort. Excuse me.
Miss Lansing, what are you doing in Hicksville?
Shopping, dear. What are you doing?
Customer sinus aisle 5, please.
Oh, look. Crenshaw melons. Why not? Maybe two.
They're so expensive.
Then I yourself, Melanie, man to the soul.
Could I have your autograph, Miss Lansing?
Oh, please. Can't you see? I'm trying to be normal.
Oh, I love these.
Poison. Isn't this fun? I haven't been shopping in years.
Haven't we got enough?
Need a box person for customer service.
That'll be $247.
I'm afraid I have only maybe $50.
Miss Lansing, could you...
Hold on, what?
What you can do? Come on, would you hold, you're holding up the line?
I don't know. What...
Add that. Don't make a scene, dear. Put our stuff in the bags. We'll send you a check.
You don't have any money?
Why should I have any money? Good old Doris. Can you change that, please? Why don't I do dinner tonight?
You?
Yes, lick of lamb. I think I can remember how to. And these fresh vegetables and fruit.
Oh, how nice. Miss Lansing.
Do stop calling me Miss Lansing. It's Laura, dear. Laura.
Well, Laura, I know how you feel about television, but there's this program that I watch. I've watched it for years. And, it's only an hour.
Which hour?
Well, it starts in 10 minutes.
But that's impossible. I'll just be settling in to work.
I'm sorry, but I have to watch The Storm Within.
Well, what the dickens is The Storm Within?
It's a soap. A soap opera, and I watch it every day.
Melody, you see now cooperative I've tried to be. I've bent over backwards to fit in so as not to disrupt your regimen. And now you insist on watching trash when I have to do a little work.
The Storm Within is not trash. It's entertainment.
Life is not just a round of pleasure, Melody. The answer is no. It has to be no. Out of my way, pygmy.
Don't you ever push my child. Listen, Laura Lansing, I don't know why you're here, but this is my house. And you are a guest here. And I will not let you abuse my children because I happen to love my children. And you will not dictate to me what I will do and what I won't do in my own home. Is that clear?
You've got a point. I have indeed transgressed the rules of decent behavior. I apologize. I shall go to my room and stand in the corner.
But I can't leave my husband. He needs me. And then to my daughter, Jennifer.
By the way, where is Jennifer?
She's out on the fire escape with that boyfriend of hers. I'm worried, Bill.
What about him?
That boy's a little too forward. I think he's up to no good. And Jennifer's putting on weight.
If I want to go, I'll go. Don't try and stop me.
You can't leave me. Not now. I'll kill myself, I swear.
Then kill yourself.
Why will she kill herself?
Because he's impregnated her.
Huh. The swine.
She never liked you anyhow.
It's the people I like, Walter, are the people I like.
I think I understand that, Violet.
If I like you, the sky's the limit.
Do you like me, Violet?
Would I be here if I didn't?
May I ask why?
I'm fascinated by older men. Especially when they got a slightly wounded look in the eye. You got a slightly wounded look in the eye.
Which eye?
It shifts.
You're so perceptive. I really feel like I can talk to you, Violet. So young, fresh, free. You don't know. My wife, she's wonderful. She's just a housewife. Sometimes I wonder, what am I doing married to a housewife?
Life isn't easy.
That's right. That's right.
But it's okay. I myself am engrossed in horticulture.
Horticulture?
I love green. Little green growing things. I have this geranium on my windowsill, and it's dying. I love it so much.
Why?
I overwater it. I can't help it.
You're so... so...
young and fresh and free.
Can I ask you a personal question, Violet?
What?
Can I see your geranium?
Barbara.
I live next door.
How do you do, Mrs. Barbara?
You just go into people's rooms and take
their
things.
There sure is something.
You know, we're not a maid.
Mom, where's Daddy's chair?
Where do you think it is?
Hush. Now go turn off your music. I warned you. Come on.
This here's Orville. He's my youngest. I got 7.
I'm not surprised.
John?
No. From what I can see, it appears to be the neighborhood pastime.
Oh.
I want my table back.
Why can't we watch television?
Because I will not spend the twilight hour with a bug-eyed boob who is too dim-witted to dig into his own inner resources to find ways to spend the time.
Just thought I'd ask.
Oh, listen, Miss Lansing. Myrtle down the street. She told me just yesterday she's so excited you're here because she read one of your books. She says it's real good.
Oh, thank you.
Except for the end. She said it went off the track, but you read it clear through.
If you'll excuse me.
Sure, honey. I know we'll just see a lot of each other this week.
Looks that way.
Quiet, Orville.
When I first saw her, I couldn't believe my eyes. I said, that can't be Laura Lansing. I fainted. I know, I remember.
I hate you.
You do.
You're a selfish, mean old...
writer. And you are a little girl, despite the fact that you're made up like Phyllis Diller on a bad night.
I'm not a little girl. I'm old enough to do it.
Another hour.
It smells delicious.
Let's open a bottle of champagne.
Well, do you think we should? I mean, 2 nights in a row?
2 nights in a row. And can't we sit in the backyard? Do you mean to tell me that you've never had any other boat but Walter?
No. There was love at first sight. Well, I'd had crushes on hopeless people like a class president or movie stars, but it was Walter. We were so young, but we decided to get married right away. And it's been wonderful ever since.
It has.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, now.
Honey. Now, if you don't forgive
him the mouth that way.
Here's to Walter.
To Walter. Of course, it isn't the same. I mean, the physical part. He has to work so hard, and he's always bone tired. I can't expect. It doesn't mean he doesn't love me.
Of course he does.
You've never been married.
Oh?
That's too bad.
Is it?
I'll be right back.
fancy, honey.
Is that our celebrity sitting there?
Sure is.
Well, what do you know? Wait till I tell Phoebe.
I have fun.
Look.
Get me the ball. Give me the ball.
Malcolm, stop that.
I told you Miss Lansing loves you.
That was Walter. He's got to work even later than usual tonight.
What have we had? A power failure?
Sit down, kids.
Why are we eating so late?
We had cocktail hour.
How can we see what we're eating?
If you can't see to eat it, Walter Jr. or Junior Walter, or whatever your name is, I will give you extra carrots.
Yeah, carrots.
It's so romantic. I think it's lovely.
I'm too young for romance.
I'm not.
Did the celebrity cook?
The celebrity cooked.
Look, lovely lamb.
I wanted hot dogs.
Chemicals.
What are we eating? A corpse.
Eat.
Okay, but I just hope you know you're eating some sheep's child.
I am Duchenne Jersey. The phenomenon of demonic possession.
Keep it down. She said you could watch it for more, but you gotta keep the volume down. I gotta go get your dad. Behave.
They hold ceremonies in which
and that? Come and help me do the dishes.
Mom does the dishes.
Well, tonight, you and Walter Jr. and I are going to do the dishes. Come on, Walter Jr. What is wrong? Well, you want to help do the dishes, too, do you?
Hi, honey. Guess what? It wasn't so bad. I kind of like her. How's your day?
Honey, don't mind. I'm too tired.
Of course. Well, we had quite a day. First, we went to the supermarket and she bought out everything. Oh, she rearranged all the furniture.
Mom, she made us do the dishes.
And I had to take out the garbage.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi, honey.
Girls wash the dishes.
Well,
how was your day, Miss Lansing?
Fine, thank you. And how was your day? Walter.
Melody.
How are you?
Good. One second. Laura!
Everything going along well?
Oh, yeah. We're having a wonderful time.
What are you doing?
At the moment, I'm vacuuming. It's for you.
Who is it?
Mr. Baumgartner.
Oh, thank you. Hello, Larry.
Hi.
Hold on just a second, will you, please? Melody, this is a little personal. Oh, would you mind?
Of course.
What did you find out? Was I right?
I think you're crazy.
I haven't been writing romantic novels for 40 years for nothing. I can look at a man's eyes and tell if he's having an affair.
Now, who'd have an affair with Walter Gompers?
That's what we've got to try to find out.
Well, I did ask Rosella. She knows everything that goes on around here.
And?
Well, she laughed, too. But then she said she thought it might be the Xerox girl. She's the office sexpot. Really just kind of chippy.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
Something wrong?
No. It's my lecture tour. I knew I'd be asked to go to Indianapolis, and I didn't want to.
Well, I hear it's pretty.
Tell me more about Indianapolis, Larry.
Indianapolis?
Seems such a far way to go. How far along is it?
I don't know, Laura. But Rosella says she thinks he's got a crush on her.
Has contact been made between the interested parties?
With Violet, I doubt if there's any other way.
Violet?
Who's Violet?
My booking agent. What do you think I should do, Larry?
Stay out of it.
Of course. I'd love to see Violet, see what she looks like.
Well, if you want to lose the bet, then come on in and look at her.
Goodbye, Larry. Keep me posted. Sometimes these tours can be so difficult.
Indianapolis isn't so bad. I had a girlfriend who moved there with her husband, and they liked it.
Here you go, Stace. Hello. Lunch?
I promised Mr. Farley.
Oh. I was crazy about your geranium, Violet.
I'm a little worried. One of its leaves is brown.
Oh. Well, I'd like to see it again sometime. Under different circumstances. What would you say if I was to tell you I love you?
Oh, that's okay. I don't mind.
Who cares about you? You're just a torn page in my book of memories.
Oh, don't torture me, Al, unless you really mean it. I've been faithful to you.
Yes, you have, you little tramp.
That looks like...
What?
Nothing.
That's Al Lamont.
I should go out and have some fun.
How can I? I'm pregnant.
Everybody's pregnant.
Only the women.
There's always a way.
Isn't he wonderful? Al Lamont, the sexiest man in soaps. Isn't he awful? How can any man do that to a woman? If that happened to me, I don't know what I'd do.
There's always a way.
The washing machine's broken. I'm going to use Francie's. You want to come?
No, I think I'll stay here and make some notes.
Are you going to write a book about us?
Maybe. Have you got a dictionary?
Oh, right over there. I'll see you later.
Want to be friends.
Where's Mom?
She's over at Francie's. No. It isn't as bad as all that.
I did what he wanted, and now he doesn't want to see me again.
What did you do?
What do you think?
In my day, it would have been a fairly innocent kiss. Have you talked to your mother or father about this?
They wouldn't care.
I think they might.
They don't know anything.
They do love you.
Nobody loves me. I used to watch Damon play basketball. Just die. He's so... All the girls are crazy about him. And I ran right into him coming out of the gym. And all of a sudden, he looked at me and he said, "Do you want to go out?" I couldn't believe it. So we had a cheeseburger. And he said he was in love with me, and he always would be. And...
I see. Listen, darling, the word love is used very loosely in this world. I love gumdrops, I love popcorn, but the real thing, seriously, is rare. Love isn't just a word. It's a wonderful happening. It takes time. Be wary. Be cautious. Even be a little bit suspicious. And above all, don't do what he wants just because he wants it.
But I was afraid I'd lose him if I did it.
No, you couldn't lose him because you didn't have him. You're young. You're building a life. Everything you do leaves a mark. Say to yourself, I'm Annette Compass, and this me is worth something. I'm of value.
But I'm not.
Well, how do you know that? There may be the most wonderful things in you just bursting to get out.
Don't laugh. Sometimes I think there are.
I'm not laughing.
I don't know what we'll do when you're gone, Laura. I'm getting so used to haute cuisine.
I wish my cook could see me.
Where's Dad?
Oh, we had to work late, honey. He's gonna come home bone tired.
Mom, is it all right if I go over to Shirley's?
Sure, just don't stay out late.
Okay. Bye, Miss Lansing.
Night, dear.
When did you two get so chummy?
Mom, can I go play ball?
Isn't it too dark?
Not if I hurry.
Okay.
What was the name of that again?
Chicken Agufero. It was some egg's mother.
Yeah, but not bad.
I'm getting used to the champagne, too. Isn't that awful? Oh, you'll be gone in just a few days.
Yep.
Are we some kind of survey?
No.
Oh, come on. Why are you here?
It's a bet. Larry, bet me. I couldn't last a week with...
Well, with what?
With a normal family.
Why couldn't you?
I'm detached from all that.
That sounds so sad.
No, no, it's not sad.
Were you ever in love?
Oh, yes.
Well, what happened?
Well, I loved him. I really did. In my way, you know. He wanted a wife, the mother of his children, and I wanted...
What?
Laura Lansing.
Are you sorry?
No, no, I don't have any regrets. I've had too lucky a life for that.
Well, I'm glad you're here.
Thank you.
Oh, there's Walter.
Hi.
Hi, honey.
We saved you some food. You want some champagne?
You people are turning into real drunks.
No, we're not. We had a wonderful day, didn't we, Laura?
Yes, we have.
Well, except that Laura has to go to Indianapolis on a lecture tour, but that's not so bad, is it?
Not so bad. Hmm. I'm going to clean up.
See, Laura? Tell Violet.
I better put the baby to bed.
Who's Violet?
Laura's booking agent.
Violet.
You think you know something, don't you? Well, you don't.
Xerox girl.
She's just a kid at the office. She's a high school dropout. She's kind of lost. She needs advice from older men.
And what do you need, Walter?
Shh, she'll hear you. Excuse me. Just what does this have to do with you?
Nothing, except that if I ever hear that you've spent one red cent on little Miss Xerox when Melody hasn't even got a decent dress, so help me, Walter, I will kill you with my bare hands.
Keep it down. Happen to love Violet.
Oh, nonsense. This is sex. Really, it's remarkable heaven. And I don't think sex has much to do with love. Unless, of course, you're lucky. And you don't strike me as being lucky, Walter.
Listen, I don't want to hurt Melody. Can't help the way I feel about this girl.
The trouble with men is that man.
What was that all about?
Oh, we were just having a little discussion.
I'll bet I know.
Walter! Soup's on!
Laura, I need to ask you a favor.
What?
Please don't nag at Walter about making more money.
Why not?
He works so hard. And it's all for us, for me, the kids. So I have to scrimp a little. I do that gladly and willingly. I'm really very lucky. He's kept a roof over our head and food in our mouths all these years.
Is that all you ask? A roof over your head and food in your mouths?
And Walter.
Who the hell is this?
It's Doris Weems, Miss Laura Lansing's secretary.
Oh, yes.
Miss Lansing is visiting some friends on Long Island, and she wondered if you could possibly lunch with them today.
I think I can arrange that.
We'll send the car for you. Is 11 o'clock all right for you?
Fine. Thank you. And thank Miss Lansing. Is it... How dressy is it?
I wouldn't worry about it. Goodbye.
No. Oh, no, that's hideous.
I don't get it. Who's coming to lunch?
An old acquaintance of mine acted in a play I once wrote. A terribly attractive man.
But why is he coming to lunch?
So you can practice, dear. Practice of being a woman. That's a bit dreary.
I'm a mother.
Well, some mothers do manage to be women.
Oh, it's beautiful. Oh, I won't look like me.
That's good.
Is lunch all ready?
It's all taken care of.
Where's Malcolm?
I took him over to Francie's. Oh, he's here.
Is this a joke?
Oh, no, sir.
Conway.
Laura, darling.
How lovely to see you.
How sweet of you to ask me.
From Emma.
Ah, in the kitchen. Are you staying to lunch?
No way. I'll be back in an hour.
What a charming room.
Isn't it? I can't wait to have you meet our hostess, Melody Gompers.
Gompers.
Such a delight. She'll be out any minute.
Are you doing research here?
In a way. Ah, here you are. Melody, this is...
You.
She's a little emotional.
Is it really you, Al?
Yes. Yes, it's me, dear.
The sexiest man in soaps.
You flatter me. I'm just plain old Conway Reed in real life. Not that we have much to do with real life. How pretty you are. With your face all flushed like that.
Isn't she?
I'm terribly bored with the soap, of course. However, I'm up for a sitcom at NBC. And there's a very good chance that I may co-star with Michael J. Fox in a new film. Well, here I am, going on about myself. Tell me about you.
Me?
All about you.
Well, I'm just a wife and mother.
Huh? Sometimes those can be the most delicious. I'd like to meet Emma sometime.
She's the best cook in New York.
Oh, have some more, Al. Excuse me, Conway.
I don't mind. Isn't she adorable?
Isn't she? Melody, could you come and help me with the dessert?
Of course.
Hurry back.
See how easy it is.
I think he really likes me.
Of course he does. By the time Walter gets home, you'll be an absolute femme fatale.
Laura. Your life must be so exciting, like Laura's. The way you live, the people you know.
Well, mine is, of course, quite glamorous. Nothing like Laura's, though.
On that glamorous note, I shall do the dishes. Oh, no. Don't hurt. You stay in Dr. Conway.
I love chocolate mousse. Before Laura came, I hadn't gone beyond ice cream.
How deliciously honest you are.
Am I?
Melody. I love your name. It's like music, isn't it?
That's what it means.
Yeah.
Do you know what we're missing? Well, at least we can catch the end of it.
Is what you want, you she-cat.
Al, why do you treat me like this?
Because I love you. I always remember that.
It's you.
The magic of tape? I can be as tender as I am tough.
Oh, Al.
About your husband.
Oh, he's an accountant. He's very nice. Only.
Only?
I don't know.
Tomorrow afternoon, my place.
What are you saying?
Something in your eyes tells me you want to see more of me.
Does they? Do they?
3 o'clock.
There's more where that came from.
Oh, I can't. The children come home from school and I...
2 o'clock.
Why not?
1 o'clock. What am I saying?
A little... cold lunch? Just the two of us?
A little cold lunch, just the two of us.
I can't. No, no, Al.
My car. In case you change your mind, I'll be waiting.
can't get over it.
What?
The way you look.
Oh, Tondaleo.
We had quite an amusing afternoon. An actor came to lunch, quite smitten with Melody and her winning ways.
What actor?
I believe Melody calls him the sexiest man in soaps.
Back to the dungeon.
Good night, Walter Jr.
Can I ask you a question?
What is it?
Should I go up for track?
Why not?
Because I'm slow.
Get faster?
How?
Well, Walter Jr., when I wanted to be a writer, I wrote and I wrote and I wrote. Your best work is habit. Run, run, run.
You can only do what you can do.
That's not true. You can do more than you can do. That's the way it goes. The more you do, the more you can do.
Okay.
Can you blame me? Entertaining men at lunch.
A friend of Miss Lansing's. Are you jealous?
Why should I be jealous? What do I care? You're not the only one attractive to the opposite sex, you know.
I know. Walter, when I was doing the laundry the other day, I noticed quite a smudge of lipstick on your collar, and I scrubbed really hard trying to get it out because I want you to look nice when we go to the office. But I would like an explanation.
The train, I guess.
The train?
Yes, honey, the train. It's crowded. People brush up against you.
Oh. Oh, Walter, I forgot to tell you. I'll need the car tomorrow. I have to go to the periodontist. Malcolm's lunch is laid out on the table. I won't be too long, I don't think.
You're overdressed up for the periodontist.
Well, I never get into Manhattan, so I thought, oh, now look, be good. And mind Auntie Laura. Good boy. Good boy. Thank you.
Tell you a story, Malcolm. Once there was a little girl. She was very bright, she was very pretty, but she was all alone. And she said, when I grow up, I'm never gonna be alone again. But she did grow up, and she was in a dark forest, and she was alone. Then she met a little boy, and his name was Malcolm. She never was alone again, but she never was alone again.
Hello, Laura. It's Conway Reed.
Oh, hello, Conway.
I just wanted to thank you for a delightful lunch.
Come.
Me too. And thanks for Melody.
Melody.
I've never met anyone like her. She's so different. By the way, is Melody there? I'd like to say hello.
I'm sorry, Conway. She's gone into Manhattan.
Oh, great. Better hustle. Thanks again for everything. Bye, dear. Hello, honey. It's 264. Take all my calls, will you? I won't be picking up this afternoon.
Conway Reed. Conway Reed.
Exciting. Come in.
I just happened to be in the neighborhood.
Of course.
Conway Reed, please.
I'm sorry, he's not picking up.
He what?
He's not picking up.
Are you sure?
Gomper speaking.
Thank goodness. I've been trying to reach you. It's Doris Weems, Miss Lansing's secretary.
I've been in a meeting.
I don't quite understand the message.
But Miss Lansing called in some agitation and asked me to tell you that the periodontist is the sexiest man in soaps. And his address is...
Hey! Francie, come! Take him!
What's the matter?
Hurry! No time, cat talk.
That was delicious. Thank you.
There's something about smoked salmon.
Isn't there?
I wish you'd have some wine.
No, I'm driving.
I can't tell you how glad I am you came.
I don't know why I did.
Don't you?
Well, Walter, can I talk to you?
Excuse me. Listen, I have to go out for a minute, and if anybody wants me, I'll...
Ah, there you are, Gompers. You know, I've just read this proposal of yours. It comes highly recommended by a client. Let's talk. Come up to my office.
Mr. Bumgarner,
You know what I think?
What?
I think we should get a little more comfortable.
Look, there's something I want to say.
What?
I guess I'm like every other woman in America. The thought of Al Lamont.
Yes.
Lunch. Alone together.
Yes.
Nothing personal, Conway, but I just wish you...
You're saying no.
Yes. It was wonderful meeting you.
Come and read.
15C.
15C.
She left.
Halliday, that's her bag. Her bag.
But the sex is male and soaked?
15C.
You've been plying her with liquor.
No, no, she's driving.
What's that door?
That's the bathroom.
What's that door?
That's the bedroom. Be my guest.
Where is she?
In the bedroom.
You.
I've got caps.
Hello, Walter. I see you two have met.
If you didn't want me to hit him, why did you get me over here?
Melody's not your cleaning woman, Walter. She's your wife. She loves you. She'd do anything in the world for you. You're not going up, you're going down.
All you do is meddle.
Walter, I was trying to save your marriage.
What do you know about marriage? You couldn't even have one.
That doesn't make me Lulu the bird girl. I'm as normal as you are.
You're normal? You're not normal. You're rich and you're famous and you make the rest of us look like 10 cents.
If you look like 10 cents, Walter, don't blame me.
Okay, so where's my wife?
There's your wife.
Walter, what are you doing here?
Let's go home.
Nothing happened.
You're a wife and mother.
You're a husband and a father. Who is she?
Nobody. A girl. The office. Went to her apartment to see her geranium.
What?
She has this geranium. Okay, honey, I admit I had ulterior motives, but...
But?
But she had one room and three roommates. One was frying an egg, one was washing her hair, and one was doing his push-ups.
Yes.
It's the new world. All I got from my trouble was a goodnight kiss. She didn't even hit my face. She hit my collar. She was looking at the geranium.
Slept so late.
Maybe they're dead.
I don't think so.
We're ready when you are, Laura. Do you want this? It was on the bathroom door. Throw it out.
Give it to me. A souvenir.
We'll wait in the car.
Okay.
Good morning.
Morning.
Oh, you're not leaving.
Any minute, your breakfast is ready.
I thought you were dead.
What's this?
I'm paying up.
Oh, thank you for everything. You know, I really shouldn't take this. But I'd never forgive myself if I didn't.
I'd never forgive you either.
I'm sorry you lost the bet.
Yeah. Well,
what's the matter?
I'm not so sure I did lose that bet. You're walking down the street, you round the corner at exactly the right moment, and you meet, for no reason, by sheer chance, the person you'll spend the rest of your life with. Why that corner? Why that moment? It isn't by chance. There is a reason. That wasn't a crazy bet. That was life saying, come on in, Laura Lansing. Join the human race.
Oh, Laura.
So, if you don't mind, I won't say goodbye. I can't. I'll just say, I love you, and I'll see you soon.
I miss you. I'm gonna win a race for you.
Eat your breakfast.
Isn't she something?
They're great, aren't they?
Laura, about the bet.
Oh, I'll tell you something, Larry. Bet or no bet, I'm gonna write something that'll knock your socks off.
I thought you might. Then don't forget my 10%.
I'm visiting today in the home of one of our literary greats. Laura Lansing has been on the top bestseller list for weeks now. And Laura, the critics are calling Suburban Serenade a classic. You've captured the heart of America. How did you do it?
Well, first I have to ask you, have you ever been to Hicksville?
Hicksville? I can't say that I have.
Don't lie. Because I have been to Hicksville. Yeah. And my trip to Hicksville was really responsible for this book. I've made great, great many trips in my life. But that trip to